Bhuteshu Padavair Asya.
Bhuteshu Padavair Asya.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Binadarshina.
Manino Binadarshina.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Vinadarshana.
Manino Vinadarshana.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Vinadarshana.
Manino Vinadarshana.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya. Namana Shantim Richati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Vinnadarshinah.
Manino Vinnadarshinah.
Bhuteshu Badhavairasya.
Bhuteshu Badhavairasya.
Namana Shantim Ichati.
Namana Shantim Ichati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Vinnadarshina.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Bhuteshu Padavairasya.
Namana Shantim Ichati.
Namana Shantim Ichati.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Vishata Parakaye Mam.
Manino Vinnadarshina.
Manino Vinnadarshina.
Bhuteshu Badhavairasya.
Bhuteshu Badhavairasya.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Namana Shantim Richati.
Vishata.
Vishata.
One who is envious.
One who is envious.
Parakaye.
Parakaye.
Towards the body of another.
Towards the body of another.
Mam. Unto me.
Unto me.
Manena.
Manena.
Offering respect.
Offering respect.
Vinadarshana.
Vinadarshana.
Of a separatist.
Of a separatist.
Bhuteshu.
Bhuteshu.
Towards living entities.
Towards living entities.
Badavairasya.
Badavairasya.
The one who is inimical.
The one who is inimical.
Na.
Na.
Not.
Not.
Mana.
Mana.
The mind.
The mind.
Shantim.
Shantim.
Peace.
Peace.
Vichati.
Vichati.
Attains.
Attains.
Translation. One who offers me respectful. One who offers me respect, but is envious of the bodies of others, and is therefore a separatist, never attains peace of mind because of his inimical behavior toward other living entities. You can repeat. One who offers me respect.
One who offers me respect.
But is envious.
But is envious.
Of the bodies of others.
Of the bodies of others.
And is therefore a separatist.
And is therefore a separatist.
Never attains peace of mind.
Never attains peace of mind.
Because of his inimical behavior.
Because of his inimical behavior.
Towards other living entities.
Towards other living entities.
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. In this verse, two phrases. Bhuteshu Badavairasya, meaning inimical towards others, and Dvishata Parakaye, meaning envious of another's body, are significant. One who is envious of or inimical towards others never experiences any happiness. A devotee's vision, therefore, must be perfect. He should ignore bodily distinctions and should see only the presence of the part and parcel of the Supreme Lord and the Lord Himself in His plenary expansion as Supersoul. That is the vision of a pure devotee. The bodily expression of a particular type of living entity is always ignored by the devotee. It is expressed herein that the Lord is always eager to deliver the conditioned souls who have been engaged or who have been encaged within material bodies. Devotees are expected to carry the message or desire of the Lord to such conditioned souls and enlighten them with Krishna consciousness. Thus they may be elevated to transcendental spiritual life and the mission of their lives will be successful. Of course, this is not possible for living entities who are lower than human beings, but in human society it is feasible that all living entities can be enlightened with Krishna consciousness. Even living entities who are lower than humans can be raised to Krishna consciousness by other methods. For example, Shivananda Singh, a great devotee of Lord Chaitanya, delivered a dog by feeding him prasadam. Distribution of prasad or remnants of foodstuffs offered to the Lord, even to the ignorant masses of people and to animals, give such living entities the chance for elevation to Krishna consciousness. Factually, it happened that the same dog, when met by Lord Chaitanya at Puri, was liberated from the material condition. It is especially mentioned here that a devotee must be free from all violence, jiva hinsa. Lord Chaitanya has recommended that a devotee not commit violence to any living entity. Sometimes the question is raised that since vegetables also have some life and devotees take vegetable foodstuffs, isn't that violence? Firstly, however, taking some leaves, twigs, or fruit from a tree or plant does not kill the plant. Besides that, jiva hinsa means that since every living entity has to pass through a particular type of body according to his past karma, although every living entity is eternal, he should not be disturbed in his gradual evolution. A devotee has to execute the principles of devotional service exactly as they are. And he must know that however insignificant a living entity may be, the Lord is present within him. A devotee must realize this universal presence of the Lord. Om
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Lord Kapila is continuing to enlighten his mother about the consciousness or the vision of a Krishna, of a pure devotee.
Om Kapil Dev, who taught me on
So he describes how a devotee does not make distinction between people simply on account of their material body.
Kapitir ka yata ba yawa tamik po ang litig ka lang kay ano?
He does not. The Krishna conscious person will simply see the super soul in the heart of the person.
Krishna ti samyuk ta hen tuk pon ta hen tuk pon ta hen dung yan hong Paramatma.
So that in the Upadeshamrita, Srila Rupa Goswami gives an example.
Srila Rupa Goswami
He said the body of the devotee is just like the water of the Ganges. So the water of the Ganges may appear to be polluted. It appears to be full of bubbles and foam and mud. So a person who is not in proper knowledge, he may think the water of the Ganges is polluted. But the Krishna conscious person will bathe in the water of the Ganges without considering So in a similar way, the body of the devotee may appear to be polluted. It may be diseased, it may be deformed, it may be lacking in many ways. But a devotee who is Krishna conscious should not minimize, should not deride, he should not neglect such a person. Should make distinction just on the basis of the body. Just like there's a story about one great sage named Astravakra. So his body was bent in many ways. It was appeared to be very deformed. So he came, there was to be some gathering of great sages, great yogis, and they were all to come to a place for a meeting. So when this Astavakra came, some of the yogis, when they saw him, they were laughing and they were ridiculing him. But Astavakra just looked at them and said, "Oh, I thought I was coming to a spiritual assembly."
Astavakra,
When you people are on the, your people are so absorbed in the material body, you're not spiritual.
ผู้คนยึดติดกับร่างกายทำให้คิดเรื่องกับความคิด
So, so this, the point is that we should not identify with the material body.
จุดมุ่งหมายก็คือเราไม่ควรคิดเรื่องร่างกายของ
Somebody may be proud to have a very healthy, very good-looking body, but this body is very temporary.
บางคนคิดว่าฉันยิ่งใหญ่หรือว่าเราสุขภาพดีแล้วว่าหรือว่าเราหล่อสวยแต่ว่าเราไม่ควรยึดติดกับร่างกาย
Somebody may be, you know, proud of their youth and their good looks, but that is just like the flower.
บางคนคิดว่าเราฉันยิ่งใหญ่ในการยิ่งใหญ่เรื่องความสวยงาม
The flower looks very nice, but very quickly it withers and dries up.
ก็เช่นเดียวเหมือนกับดอกไม้จะสวยงามแป๊บนึงแล้วเดี๋ยวแป๊บนึงก็เน่าเลย
So in the same way, the temporary material body, all of our good looks and our health and our strength, it's all very temporary.
ที่โลกวัตถุนี้มันจะเป็นชั่วคราวหมดเลยเรื่องความสวยงามหรือว่าเรื่องความยิ่งใหญ่อะไรเราจะหายไป
We were just singing Itana Yovana Putra Parijana Itiki Achipara Titiri Kamala Dala Chalachi Manatala Pajaru It's the meaning is that these things like our money, our youth, our childYou may have a son, you're proud of having a child, but these things are all very temporary. They're just like a drop of water on the leaf of a lotus. So Lord Kapila is instructing the importance of having spiritual vision, not being blinded by the external glitter.Of the material world.
Om Kapila Dev, talk about the duty of qualities, and not just
We have to see through the eyes of the scriptures. That is real vision.
We have to see through the eyes of the scriptures. That is real vision.
People who are looking at the material body, then they will always feel bitterness and envy towards others, and then they will never be peaceful. So it's important that we have a nice relationship with everyone.
เราควรที่จะมีความสัมพันธ์ที่ดีกับทุกคน
If we are envious of somebody.We think, oh, this person's got more money, or this person's better looking, or this person's got more success in their life than me.
If we
We will simply spend all of our time lamenting about our past, about our life. And we'll be thinking and planning about the future. In other words, we'll keep up, have a lot of material desires. So this is the cause of material existence. Lord Kapila wants his mother to come up with the, to give up this material existence. So he's telling her what should be our, what should be the mood, what to see, how to see others. We should see that the Lord in the heart of everyone. Somebody is enjoying good karma and other people are suffering some bad karma. But every living entity is a pure spirit soul. Prabhupada gave the example, he told the story about liquid beauty. There was the beautiful young woman, and the lusty man came by and he was attracted to the beautiful young woman. So the woman told the man, "You please just come back after a week and I will enjoy with you. I will enjoy with you." So for 1 week this woman was taking medicine and she had diarrhea and she was passing a lot of stool and vomiting. And then when after a week when the man came back, he was looking, where is the beautiful young woman? The woman said, "No, it's me, I'm that woman." And the man was, "What? You?" The woman was no longer beautiful. So he asked the woman, "What, if you are that, where is your beauty?" So then she showed the man all of the vomit and all of the stools that she had been passing. So there is truth and there is beauty. So beauty of the material body is not truth because it's very temporary.
างวัตถุมันจะชั่วคราว
but if you understand the real truth the nature of the soul is beautiful
ถ้าเราเข้าใจความจริงของความสวยงามของดวงวิญญาณเราก็จะรู้จักความสวยงามที่แท้จริง
so we should try to see the soul in all forms of life
เราควรที่จะพยายามควรพยายามในการเห็นดวงวิญญาณของเราเพื่อไปหา
and if we see the presence of Krishna if we see the Lord in the heart of everyone then we will not be violent
ถ้าเราไม่เห็นถ้าเราเห็นองค์พระบรมในทุกคนหรือว่าทุกมวลชีวิตเราก็จะไม่เป็นแบบนี
้ so Prabhupada explains that people say well you're violent to the vegetables because you're killing the vegetables
พระบรมบอกเธอก็รุนแรงต่อพืชผักผลไม้เช่นเดียวกัน
but we don't really kill them we just take the leaves or we take the fruits
เราไม่ได้ฆ่าเขาแต่ว่าเราแค่เอาก็ใบหรือว่าผลของต้นไม
้ and whatever we take we offer to Krishna
เรารับอะไรหรือว่าเราซื้ออะไรมาเราก็จะ
and because it's offered to Krishna then these plants and trees and everything they all benefit they all get a human form of life in the future
สิ่งที่เราถวายต่อ Krishna แล้วก็พวกที่ถวายให้กับพิชนาและพวกนั้นก็จะชาติหน้าอาจจะเกิดเป็นมนุษย์หรือว่าเป็นพิชนา
so we're being kind to all of these plants and fish
เราเมตตาต่อพืชผักผลไม้
we're helping them come to the human form of life
เรากำลังช่วยพวกเขาให้มาในร่างมนุษย์
And the human form of life is possible for people to understand spiritual knowledge. We cannot tell the dog, you are a soul, control your senses.
เราไม่สามารถบอกหมาได้ว่าเธอคือดวงวิญญาณเธอก็ต้องควบคุมประสาทสัมผัส
You cannot expect to communicate that kind of knowledge to the animals
เราไม่สามารถให้ความรู้ด้านนั้นให้กับสัตว์ได
้ But we can give mercy to them by giving them prasadam
เราให้ความเมตตาต่อพวกสัตว์ได้ด้วยการให้
And they also benefit by hearing the holy name. Hari Das Thakur explained to Lord Chaitanya that the chanting of the holy names benefits all living entities.
Hari Das Thakur bok Chaitanya Mahaprabhu va pranam sasit khong Krishna สามารถช่วยทุกคนได้ทุกชีวิตทุกคน
โอเค any questions
Maharaj my friends asked me that those who commit good deeds go to the heavenly pen so he was asking if all the cows and all these animals go to the heavenly planet with their own body because they don't really commit any bad deeds or something
No.
So, why don't they? Are they going to the heavenly planets?
No. Usually, a cow will get a human body in the next life. The soul from the cow, in the next life gets a human body. The cow is an animal in the mode of goodness, generally. Although it's an animal, some nature is more of the mode of goodness. So, generally, the cow is the highest.Form in the animal species, and the next body after the cow is the human body. So the soul in the cow becomes a human. There's an evolution through these different species. species, and the cow is the highest form. That's why, one of the reasons why we give so much care, we take care of cows, we have to protect them. To kill a cow is very simple. So the cow, it also it has some karma. If you're in an animal body, you see the animal body is a karma. That's the karma you get. Now, animals themselves, they don't suffer karma, but that body itself is karma. But they're not getting any more karma. They're working off their karma. They're using up their karma in that animal body. And when they've finished off all their karma, which brings them in the animal body, then they come to the human body. Of course, in the human body, they still have karma. But it's not as bad as in the animal body. But the cows, they won't go to heaven anymore. They're not doing anything sinful. That's true for any animals. That, but even the tiger and so on may kill, but it's not actually, it's not going to get karma. It's not going to get karma. But that animal body which it has, that is its karma. It's suffering. Well, what do you mean, previous karma?
Like, you know, like because we said that animal will finish off their karma and then they will get the human body, right,
huh? Well, they finish off some of their karma.
Yeah.
They're going to come in the human body, they have to have some karma. That's why they're taking birth. But they're coming up from a lower species. Coming up from a lower species, so the karma is not so bad. And you can see some dogs, it appears like their karma is not so bad, you know, they live in the luxury house. They sit all day in the air-conditioned house. And eat the food, don't do anything. You know, they have a... That's their karma. But they still got some karma. So they take a human, gradually they come back to the human form of life. But in the purport here, Prabhupada was explaining how one dog was liberated by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. And so even animals can be liberated. Rasikananda, there was this one devotee, he was a disciple of Shamananda. Shamananda had studied in Vrindavan at Jiva Goswami's Gurukula. So he had a disciple named Rasikananda, and Rasikananda had some animals who were his disciples. One elephant, called the elephant Gopal. Gopal Das got initiation. And he was in the elephant was destroying the village, but Rasikananda came up and chanted the holy name, and the elephant fell at his feet. And then also said some tigers also got initiated. Said Narada Muni initiated a snake. He told the snake, now don't bite anymore. Huh?
sometimes, you know, when we talk like this, one of the arguments that I got is like, you know, after they evolve, then they'll get a human body. So, you know, someone was saying, so, you know, if I kill a cow, if I kill something, they'll get a human body, so it's actually good for them, you know. I can eat their meat.
No, if you kill a cow, it's not good because they have to take birth again because they didn't finish their time.
They have to finish their time, right?
Yeah.
That's the same with also the human being, or if you commit suicide or something, then if you're not supposed to, then we will get a ghost body or something.
Yeah. You get a ghost body if you commit suicide.
I think in today's look there was written, don't disturb the gradual
development.
Yeah. Right. Don't disturb the natural evolution of the soul.
So the animals we kill, they will again have to come and take their body and finish off their animal life, and then only they get the human body.
Yeah. That's why it's very bad to kill the animal. Just let them work off their karma naturally. Okay. Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jaya.